In this video, I'd like to introduce you to HIPS-Filament, a very affordable yet universal material. Over the last couple of months, I have printed a lot with the filament and tested everything, from its mechanical and thermal properties to its use as a support material thanks to its solubility in limonene. So stay tuned for an exciting test here at JanTec Engineering. High impact polystyrene, or HIPS for short, is a versatile and cost-effective material that is frequently used in the plastics industry. It consists of a combination of polystyrene and polybutadiene, which is distributed as rubber particles in the polystyrene matrix. This leads to improved impact strength and resistance to physical stresses, as the name high impact suggests. HIPS is used in packaging, toys, and household appliances such as refrigerators. As filament, HIPS is offered by many different manufacturers. One of its main features is its solubility in limonene, which makes it suitable for use as a support material for ABS. I will of course also test this, even though I failed miserably at first. Nevertheless, HIPS filament itself promises good mechanical properties, which is why several people asked me for a test in the comments. Filamentum sent me a spool some time ago that had been sitting on the shelf ever since. After further research, I realized that HIPS is generally offered very cheaply, sometimes for less than 10 euros per kilogram. As Filamentum is a relatively expensive, let's call them a premium manufacturer, I wanted to include one of the cheaper options in the test as well. So I bought a spool of HIPS in blue on Amazon, 1 kilo for under 15 euros. The material comes from China, and I strongly assume that this is quite similar, if not identical, to the other no-name HIPS filaments you can buy on AliExpress, eBay, and Amazon worldwide. Overall, I was surprised at how many of the well-known manufacturers have HIPS in their product range. There are also some recycled options. You can find all the links in the video description. Now let's move on to printing with the filaments. It should be said that I have never worked with HIPS before. For this test, I wanted to use the Prusa XL, which is why I first loaded the HIPS from Filamentum into the printer. I used the generic HIPS settings in the slicer and started a banshee. To avoid bad adhesion problems, I also applied a thin layer of Vision Miner nano adhesive to the textured print sheet. After the banshee came out absolutely perfect, I immediately printed out all the test specimens for my mechanical tests. The parts look very good and feel high quality. The matte surface appears hard and scratch resistant. Then it was time for the blue no-name HIPS from China. Even though the packaging doesn't look like it, the filament itself makes a relatively good impression. The diameter is right and the color looks consistent. I therefore printed out all the samples for the tests using the same G-code. Again, everything adhered well. The odor development was also reasonable, comparable to ABS. In case anyone is wondering why I don't use an enclosure, the printer sits under the roof in our house, and since it's summer while filming this video, the room is warm. Conditions are therefore comparable with an enclosed printer. I have also verified this using professional measuring equipment. In colder garage or basement rooms, an enclosure could be helpful. As always, let's start with the tensile test. Anyone familiar with my filament test videos will know that I have always tested with such a manual test stand. In the meantime, I have finally managed to finish designing my own motorized version. This allows modular exchange of holders for different test specimens. The motor then pulls on the sample with the load cell until it breaks. At the same time, the applied force is measured and recorded. I ordered the printed parts for the tensile test from JLC3DP, the sponsor of today's video. At JLC3DP, you can get your parts 3D printed in a wide range of materials at a reasonable price. They offer SLA, MJF, SLM, FDM and SLS printing in a wide range of materials and finishes. Their advanced online platform allows for easy 3D model uploads, instant quotes and real-time order tracking. From material selection to rapid delivery of finished products, they manage every step carefully, with production times as fast as 24 hours and delivery within just 2 days. I ordered the parts for my tensile test in clear resin and black nylon from SLS and MJF. I also had this sample printed in metal, and look at the quality. Check out what they can do and get up to $60 new user voucher at the link below. Now back to the test. I printed my standard samples 4 times in the XY orientation and 4 times in Z orientation. I came up with an average tensile strength of just over 23 MPa for both filaments, which is relatively low compared to other filaments. The strength in the Z direction as a measure for layer adhesion is similar to that of ABS at approximately 10 MPa. So far, the results are not particularly good, so let's take a look at the other properties. The 3-point bending test can be used to determine the bending modulus as a measure of stiffness. Weights, in my case empty glass bottles, get attached to the sample, which applies force to it. Since the weights are known and the bending can be measured from above using a precision indicator, the bending modulus can be calculated using this formula. I obtained a value for the blue hips of 2137 MPa and 1709 MPa for the natural hips from filamentum, which means that it is slightly more bendable. These values are roughly comparable to the stiffness of ABS and PETG. The notched bar impact test can be used to analyze resistance to sudden loads. In this test, notched specimens are smashed in the center by a swinging hammer. From the height difference and constants, such as the weight of the hammer, the impact resistance can be calculated in kilojoules per square meter, meaning energy per area. I had high expectations for this test, as the term high impact is in the name of the filament. The test confirmed these expectations. With the blue hips, I achieved an average notched impact strength of 15.9 kJ per square meter, with the filamentum hips slightly less at 14.7 kJ per square meter. Compared to PLA or PETG, these are very good values. Now to the temperature test. As always, I performed this test in the convection oven with the beams from the bending test with 30% gyroid infill loaded with a nut in the middle. The test revealed a temperature resistance of approximately 75 to 80 degrees Celsius for both filaments. Especially in comparison to ABS, this is a point where HIPS performs not so good. Now a brief comparison with other common filaments. From now on, I will no longer only compare prices in euro per kilogram, but mainly in euros per meter. In the past, I have often noticed that materials with a significantly lower density, such as PP, perform worse in the price comparison. With a density of only 1.05 grams per cubic centimeter, a meter of blue HIPS costs less than 4 cents, while the filamentum costs just under 9 cents, comparable to Prusameter and PLA. In general, I still find it difficult to compare costs, as prices vary greatly depending on the manufacturer. If you want to include other manufacturers in the comparison, you could simply calculate the price per meter using the density from the datasheet and the price per kilogram. You can also simply calculate and compare the price in other units, such as US dollars per inch. Now a few more properties that could be relevant for some applications. HIPS is compatible with ABS, which means that the print settings are almost identical and the materials adhere to each other. In addition, HIPS can be dissolved in limonene, which makes it a good support material for ABS in particular. I'll show you more details in a moment. HIPS is also easy to process, meaning it can be sanded, cut, drilled and painted. This can be very interesting for modeling. The filament is only minimally hygroscopic, which means that it does not necessarily have to be dried. My experience also confirms this. I stored the spools open for over 2 months and did not notice any changes in the print quality or other signs of moisture. On the negative side, however, it should be emphasized that HIPS, like ABS, contains styrene, which is released when heated. It should therefore be possible to ventilate the room. I would also recommend a filter in the printer cabinet. Now let's take a look at the use of HIPS as a support material for ABS parts. It can be quite annoying and time-consuming to remove complex support structures. Multi-material printers such as the Prusa XL or various IDEX systems are able to print the supports from a different filament, such as a soluble material. BVOH, for example, can be easily dissolved in water, but has the disadvantage that it is hygroscopic and very expensive. As already mentioned, HIPS can be dissolved in limonene. To test this, I ordered a bottle of D-limonene and printed a few sample prints from Nobofil ABS-X with HIPS supports on my Prusa XL. I had previously read on the internet that limonene does not affect the ABS and it can take several days for the HIPS to dissolve. So I left the parts in limonene overnight. The next day, when I went to take my finished parts out of the solution, I realized that the ABS had also been damaged by the limonene. The parts simply crumbled away. My guess is that the Nobofil ABS-X is not just pure ABS, but also contains other polymers or fillers. Manufacturers often produce such blends. Overall, I'm sure that this can work without any problems with the right ABS and the necessary fine-tuning, but I won't do it any further myself as the limonene is expensive and difficult to handle in terms of safety and disposal. However, I think that HIPS can do much more and is by far not just a support material. Its good mechanical properties and ease of printing make it a good all-rounder for me and a worthy replacement for ABS. I have therefore printed many everyday spare parts and prototypes from HIPS. I also mentioned earlier that components made from HIPS are relatively easy to process. That's why I also printed this design for an architecture project from HIPS. Here is a summary of all the test results at one glance. Advantages are the low price, the similarity to ABS, particularly high impact strength, and the possibility of using it for support structures. The disadvantages are the tendency to warp, toxic styrene, and lower resistance to certain solvents and strong acids. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I'm always trying to improve the quality of my test methods and videos, which is why your feedback is very important. I would therefore be very pleased to read from you in the comments. Thanks and see you next time here at JanTec Engineering.